NCTV45, the train, anytime on your time.
J&J Padula Show.
Wait a minute.
J&J, what?
Wait a minute.
It's Cinco de Mayo.
Hey.
Well, that's when we're filming anyhow. It's on
no,
Cinco de Mayo.
No.
Yeah. Like that. How are you going to explain this music away?
Wait a minute.
We can't explain the music away.
It's,
Cinco de Mayo.
No. No, I did not. I'm really tired of this. It's the U-Beer guy.
He just follows us everywhere now.
We have no clue why.
Everywhere.
What? What are you doing?
It's Cinco de Mayo!
That's Larry in Poland, Ohio on 224.
Or Center Street.
That's where we're at. Larry's. Good
no, wine. No, that's where we're at.
Huh?
That's where we're at.
No, he doesn't have an app.
No, he has
the hat. I know he
has
a friend. He does. And you have a hat. I don't wear a hat.
No, because...
Really? No, I wouldn't look good. Look,
that's a good look
at this.
I like it.
No. I don't look right.
Jimmy Buffett concert.
Yeah.
That's
hey.
Not you.
Welcome to the show. We are so excited because one, we are on NCTV 45. Two, we are on V3 TV in the UK.
Soon to go Roku.
Roku.
We're gonna. Roku.
Like that old Street Fighter game.
Haruki.
Yeah. And then the guy that would spin around. What were some of the other things that they do?
Excuse us.
What? Yeah, go ahead.
Haruki.
Is that what he says?
When are you going to get a car?
I thought it was Hadouken.
Haruki.
That's the U-Beer guy, as I was explaining.
Haruki.
He still is contracted to drive us around. No keys. No car, nothing. So now he just hangs out on his set for whatever reason. I have no clue.
I've been sitting here for 3 days waiting for you guys to come to this location.
Why?
Because you told
But we, you have to pick us up, that you beer driver.
I don't have a car yet. What part of that don't you get?
Then how are you qualified to be a U-Beer driver?
Yeah.
That's part of the qualification
because
process.
I gave them my parents' VIN number and insurance information. Duh.
Wow. You know why? I'm gonna need a ride this weekend.
Okay, I'll pick you up.
You will?
Maybe.
You know what? I'm so excited about Stretch Marks located in Wampum, the no class, low class strip club. This week, they're gonna have a play.
A plague?
A plague. Well, you could probably get a plague, but
like
listen.
Frogs?
No,
flies?
A plague.
The
a plague.
Can be red.
Blood. And here it is right here.
Or catch on fire.
Blood. It is.
That only happens in the
I have
river.
It right here. They gave me all the information. Here it is.
Is there a particular reason we're yelling?
I don't know.
I don't know.
Over the music?
No.
What?
Are we yelling? We apologize.
Like we're yelling. If we're yelling, we apologize.
We apologize.
Like my new scarf, I found another really
so
beautiful.
This weekend, and there are a lot of things that are happening, but it's Stretch Marks. This weekend, they have a play, and it's a fundraiser for their Little League team.
A play.
A play, P-L-A-Y.
Not a plague.
No. And it's for their Little League team to raise money to buy
shirts. What's the name
shirts.
Of their Little League team?
Huh?
What's the name of their Little League team?
Yes. Listen, so the name
easy
of the
to print.
Yeah.
Yes.
Well, so that's all they ever say.
The play at Stretch Marks, and this is the information I have, is I Knocked Up Satan's Daughter.
Oh.
And yeah, it's a demonic romantic comedy. So that sounds like a lot of fun. Tickets are on sale.
Isn't that like a Dom Com?
Yeah. Donkey Kong. Yeah. No. And it's starring probably one of the best actresses in a strip club circuit, Haunted Vagina. So she'll be there, and it's you know what? I think the tickets.
I
gonna be a good
fundraiser. She won a Tony for that.
How'd you know that? So, just go.
She was completely confused by the award.
Yeah, but thank you.
They said they're gonna give her a Tony, and
really,
like, is he Italian?
Yeah. Yeah, thank you. So, hey, if you get a chance, it's for a great cause.
What was her name again?
Haunted Vagina.
Makes sense.
Wow. And you know what? Have you ever seen that play before?
No.
Wow. It's good.
Yeah.
It's a good play. That's why it's worth going back.
I hear she's kind of echoey though on stage.
Yes. Today. I'm the happiest. Anyway. And there's another little thing that's happening. It's stretch marks. And in fact, there's so many things happening. I had to write them down because I didn't want to. Why am I talking to you?
Do you have fluid on the brain?
Huh?
Do you have fluid on the brain?
No. Here it is right here. Oh, and then the owner of Stretch Marks, located in Waltham, Pennsylvania, has a new book out. And it's called, the title of the book is Magical World of Rectal Probes by Dr. Dick Likens. And Likens is spelled with two K's. So that's another thing that they're going to be selling.
It's three K's.
No, it's two K's. So when you're down there,
what's the name of the book?
It's called The Magical World of Rectal Probes by Dr. Dick Likens. So, and then I'll mention some more stuff as the week goes on. It's a beauty. So
he also wrote The Shrinking Universe of Gonorrhea.
He did?
Yes.
I didn't know that. Wow. So
first second bestseller.
I am so happy that they really, really, really have come a long way in Stretch Marks and how they contribute. Thank you, you got that. How they contribute to society and the community of Waltham so that they could have a Little League baseball team, and if things go well, they will have a Pop Warner football team.
What's that mean?
You know what? What they're gonna do? Well, you know, I'll get into it tomorrow. I wrote some things down.
You have written down?
You know what? You beer guy?
Yes, sir.
You're gonna be on the committee. The selection committee for names.
Okay.
So I'm very excited about this. I'm also excited that we're
It was hilarious. Probably a bad idea to tape outside today.
Why?
Can they be the stretch mark stretchies?
That's not bad. Listen, ladies and gentlemen, if you get a chance, if you want to write in or email whatever about some names for the Little League baseball team. Yeah, the stretch mark stretchies, I like that. It's pretty good. Very, very good.
You can reach us at NCTV45.com, NCTV45@gmail.com. You can contact us at 724-510-7345. That number again, 724-510-73.
That's very good.
Thank you.
That's very good. I'll tell you. And hopefully, one of these days, soon, Melissa will show up to do another episode with us. What do you think?
Yeah.
Hey, and listen, ladies and gentlemen, the Hillary Clinton.
I was supposed to pick Melissa up today. I completely forgot.
What?
That's my bad.
I gave you over $300.
That's
not only
my
to drive
bad.
Us.
That's
but
my bad.
To pick up your guest.
To pick up the guest.
Yes.
I'm thinking we should film inside tomorrow.
You think?
Huh?
What?
That's your line.
Yes.
Huh? Hey, Mr. Hey!
That's Mr. Johnston.
You know,
he coaches Little League Baseball.
I think tomorrow on the show, Lou Holtz.
Yes, I heard. Through our booking agent.
Wow.
It took some finagling on our part, but we did convince him. Now, don't worry. You don't have to pick him up.
No, don't.
Lou likes to drive himself.
Yeah. And you know what I love about Lou Holtz? You know, he's come out.
Oh, he came out finally.
Trump.
I knew.
No. He's all for Trump, and I really, really respect him, so we got to get him on the show. In fact, he is going to be on the show. He's going to be on tomorrow. And then he did email me, and I guess he wants to discuss this safe place garbage that they're doing on college campuses now.
Yeah, he's not happy about it.
No, he's not.
He's old school.
He is. Remember.
He's also old.
Oh, come on.
Is he as old as Mr. Weatherby?
No. He did say at one point, when I spoke with him, he said that the candles, he's older than the candles on his cake. That's what he said to me, Lou Holtz.
I don't think that makes sense.
Yeah, huh? Candles,
candles
are pretty,
aren't that old.
They're not. Pretty regularly.
The candles are older than Lou.
There you go. That's what you're looking for.
No, what did I say?
That he's older than the candles.
He's older than the candles.
That's wrong.
Right.
No, the candles.
That's funny.
That is.
That is wrong.
Yeah.
Huh?
He, Yeah. Huh. What, Lou? You? Me.
What?
You, Burr. Beer.
New beer.
New beer.
New beer.
New beer. How's that business? You know what? I noticed on our market.
Fantastic. We're doing really good.
No, I mean, with the U-Beer guy, I mean, I noticed that the people who are driving that actually have the app, the U-Beer app and everything, I think they made like, it's now the U-Beer is worth about $10 million now.
I don't see any of that.
Yeah, because you don't drive. You don't even leave the garage.
I'm a horrible driver.
You don't need, listen to me, you haven't driven because you don't have the car. It's unbelievable.
Maybe,
unbelievable. Yeah.
Maybe I'll get a car within the next week or so.
We were collecting.
You were?
Well, you know what?
Did you give me any of it?
No, because it's in the safe down at Stretch Mark.
Well, we'll never see that.
Yeah.
There's not a safe down at Stretch Mark.
There isn't?
No. It's a, did Gina put it in that hole in the wall that says safe that's written in Sharpie with an arrow?
Well, that was in a bathroom.
Right.
And the hole.
And it says safe, written in Sharpie?
Didn't say safe.
No, okay.
Said,
I'm talking about the other hole. This is going downhill.
No, it can't be going downhill. Listen, we still have 100,000 views a day. We are number one. In fact, let me tell you something. This is on, yes, we are number one. KDKA, I spoke with some people from KDKA Radio.
Sylvia? You talked to Sylvia?
Sylvia! What?
She don't like me.
Who?
Sylvia.
Why not?
KDKA.
Why?
She says we're too risque as a show.
Why would she
we're
say
too
that?
Out there.
Do you think we are? Hello?
I think somebody just robbed somebody's car.
No. What he's, do you say now?
That dude's tweaking. He is tweaking.
Yeah, he looked at
it. Look out for the tweakers.
You think he's upset? Yeah, he just drank that whole beer.
He chugged the beer, now he's driving.
You know what? I think his girlfriend's in trouble or his boyfriend's
got,
in trouble.
You got $5?
Hey, I got a Weller story to tell you. Can I tell you this? You got coffee over here. No, you got to actually, you have a drinking problem, I see. Listen.
That's why I use the straw.
Yeah, use the straw. Listen, here's what happened with Weller.
What?
Weller.
Who?
Here's what happened with this guy. Remember I told you last week about Mr. Weller?
Tweaking.
And,
what?
No, we weren't tweaking. He was twerking with his wife. And I went down to get that piece to the weed whacker. Okay?
Oh, down at the antique store.
No, Weller's.
Is that where you put your drugs in the weed whacker?
No. So here's what happened. So I go down. I said, hey, Mr. Weller, you know, I placed the order.
Did you order?
What?
The drugs.
Yeah.
No, the weed whacker.
The weed?
You didn't?
So here's what happened.
How come you didn't?
Huh?
The drugs.
No. There weren't anybody drunk at Weller's.
Drunk what?
Nobody was drunk at Weller's.
Weed.
No.
Right.
Go, all the show on Showtime weeds.
Huh?
That's a pretty good show. I like it. It got a lot of awards. Won a lot of awards. Weeds. You ever see that show?
Weed. Yeah, I love weed.
Weeds.
Yeah.
Weeds with that guy.
It'll do in a pinch. It's not really my preference, but
what is?
It'll do in a pinch.
What will?
He likes a pinch.
Pinch.
Skull?
No.
Just between your cheeks and gums?
No.
What? You know what you need to do? You need to volunteer down at Stretch Marks. It's a drug-free zone.
Right.
You
stand outside and you
don't forget
pat
the play to
down
spin.
For
I was going to have the dancer. She was supposed to be on the show today, but she didn't have a ride. I told you the dancer's name.
His number?
Yeah, here.
You call him? You call him?
I took care of it.
He can be
you
here?
Did?
Is that him?
Yep.
She left her number two, but you never picked her up.
Number two? No, I'm good. I'm a little constipated, actually.
I can't believe you didn't pick up Haunted Vagina.
I don't know. She wasn't on my list.
I have it right here. You were supposed to pick her up at 9 a.m. to be here on the show, be a guest.
Did you call me to tell me that?
You think they have Robitussin in there?
Huh?
You think they have Robitussin in there?
Some Robitussin.
Need some Tussin.
Well, listen. So, anyway, just one more time. Again, to play at Stretch Marks this weekend.
Give me some.
It's I Knocked Up Satan's Daughter. It's a demonic romantic comedy.
Get whatever they have.
It's
unbelievable. It's a rom-dom-com.
It is. It is. And it's a great stuff. Great stuff. And just make sure you go down there. It's for a good cause, as we said before. It's to get the baseball uniforms.
What's the baby's name?
What baby?
Well, they have.
You can sell those for drugs.
Jane. Who? That
Jane?
Guy?
Jane who?
No.
Mary Jane?
No.
What?
Yeah.
You have
them? Really?
Mary Jane Blood.
Where? Do you have some?
No. Who does that anymore? It's all legal now.
Is
you
it?
Can go get it. Yes.
Where?
In Pennsylvania.
I guess Joel's gone.
Anyway, I'm so happy that, come on. How about that, ladies and gentlemen, how about that band? There we go, right there. And with the Cinco de Mayo dancers. Look at that go. Uh-huh. Yeah. Hey, here's one thing I say to everybody when I promote the show. It doesn't cost you a penny. It's free. So what do you care, right? You tune in, you watch, you get a few laughs, and you have one of the best dancers.
Or you don't laugh.
You don't laugh, but he was kicked off of...
Dancing with the Scoundrels.
Yes, Dancing with the Scoundrels on A&E.
Yeah.
Season 3, mm-hmm. He was kicked off
because
he was dating... One of the dancers haunted vagina.
Yeah.
And the word got out. And here, he actually won, but he was disqualified when they found out about haunted vagina. So, anyway.
Sad day.
Huh?
It's a sad day.
It was a sad day. But hopefully it'll turn. There we go. Oh, look how nice.
Oh, my hat's back.
So he's just. Is that riffing? What was that called when you. Or is that Coke? I mean, no, what is that?
Huh? It's a Coke?
Hey, what was up with that guy?
We got
the guy that...
Cocaine? No.
Chugged the beer? But so nice.
I don't
nice.
Know nothing. I didn't see nothing. I ain't saying nothing.
Don't go in the bathroom for a little bit.
Why?
Just don't touch the sink.
You're not like that. See, people know you're not like that.
Don't touch the sink.
Why? Why? Where is Melissa?
I spilled aspirin on the sink.
Was it crushed up?
Yeah.
Okay.
It gets in your bloodstream a lot better that way.
Really?
Yeah. Huh?
Are you okay?
You're good.
I'm good.
Anyway, again, you can catch us on NCTV45, B3TV in the UK, and soon to be on Roku. I think June or July, we'll be on
else
Roku.
You?
Huh?
Anybody else itchy?
Come to think of it, I am.
You are?
Yeah.
From what? Allergies. Oh, were you down at stretch marks?
Well.
You weren't? Okay. That's...
Ready to go do something.
What do you mean?
Let's go running or something. You want to go run?
Like, I already ran.
26.2, buddy. 26.2.
For what?
26.2. Marathon.
Have you ever participated in a marathon?
Huh?
Have you ever participated?
No, I don't get gas there. Gas
really?
Crack. Yeah, all water down. Yeah, no crack. I'm gonna do. You gotta break it down and you smoke it. It's much better.
That's something.
So crack. Yeah, crack is crack. You're, whack.
Who's this guy? This guy's leaving the country over here. He's
got that's Bill. I'll be right back.
Who is it?
It's Bill.
Where's my?
He's my sponsor.
Hey, I know Bill.
I guess
that's
a sponsor. Yes. I didn't know
that he needed a sponsor, but I mean.
You know,
ever since he went to Virginia.
Virginia, yeah.
So,
how's Bill?
How's Bill? I bet you
still
went to see Bill.
Bill.
Uh-huh. Bill.
I think Bill's his dealer.
No.
Not dealer, no. I got a car.
That's not the kind of show we have. We don't have people that do drugs or drink and stuff like that. Whoa,
look out.
Whoa,
there goes.
Your book is going
crazy.
My book,
yeah.
I'm going to put my hat down
since it's fall off. Put your hat down. It's windy. You think tomorrow
we could be inside? Wow, is that music loud?
No, I don't
We're
think
yelling
so.
Again.
Music loud.
I think tomorrow.
So, yeah, I went down to Virginia, and like we played golf all day. And then it was like we're in the sun and down by the river. And we got down by the river, and it was like really wet, and there was like fishing going through there. And then I told the one guy, I said, look at all these golf balls down in there. He's like, oh my gosh, look at all the golf balls. I was like, yeah, because the Lord of Fishes looks like there's a bunch of eggs down there. It was crazy. I couldn't understand it. It got really hot.
Really?
Yeah.
How was your game down there?
Huh?
How was your game?
What game?
No, I said, are you in a gang? No.
Hey, Bill's calling you.
Huh? Bill. Bill. Hey, he's got to go see his sponsor. Well, listen, we appreciate you watching the show. Once again, the insanity, the goofiness, the silliness, that's how we bring it to you all the time. And now, we don't see.
Thanks, Bill.
He's your sponsor, you said.
Huh? Who's sponsor?
Huh?
Chip?
Who?
Right, that's that Little League team. Little League team.
Who?
Little League team.
No.
Little League team. Little League team. Stretch marks, Little League
stretch
team.
Marks,
sponsor.
Stretchers.
They sponsor.
Stretchies.
Why don't you give them what a call if they want to call?
Huh?
What tone?
Call Bill. It's 724.
Hey, don't forget, ladies, before I go, don't forget
610.
Make sure when you're down at Stretch Marks,
55.
Make sure you buy. Make sure you buy the new book. Okay, The Magical World of Rectal Probes by Dr. Dick.
I just read it.
Likens. And remember,
it's
LIKKE. 2 Ks. Hey, we'll see you tomorrow.
Does that mean we're done?
Hey.
I think there's Bill again.
Who knows?
Hey, Bill!
Bill!